It's the National Football League on EA Sports, and tonight's Clash of Conferences is just moments away. It's the Giants and the Chiefs on Monday Night Primetime.
Well, the sun has gone down, and so has the temperature, as EA Sports welcomes you to GEHA Field at venerable Arrowhead Stadium in Kansas City. A few short moments ago, these two teams made their way out of the Arrowhead Stadium tunnels, and the noise level in this place was just about off the charts. They're set for football as the Chiefs get set to do battle with the New York Giants. With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden, and CD, our matchup here in this one, as so many do, revolves around the quarterback position. We've got an interesting pairing here. Daniel Jones of the Giants, Patrick Mahomes of the Chiefs.
And Brandon, I think each one might be trying to play some form of keep away from the other, because when you think about time of possession and what that means in a game, it's great if you're able to hold on to the football and run your offense at your pace. And it also helps to keep the other guy's offense on the sideline. That's your goal for the game.
The kicker, Graham Gano, set to put his foot into this one. And we are underway from Arrowhead. And here comes a return from just beyond the goal line. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. But the Chiefs offense now ready to go to work for the first time, led by Patrick Mahomes, the 2018 NFL Most Valuable Player.
And while I don't equate starting record as a quarterback to pitchers in baseball, it still gives us a great baseline. And Patrick Mahomes, 38-8 as a starting quarterback for Kansas City in the regular season. Throw in 6-2 in the playoffs, including a Super Bowl 54 victory. You've got one of the best ones in the game. And if you're a Kansas City fan, how excited are you? He signed through 2031. He will be your quarterback for a long time.
So here's a 1st and 10 now down inside the 20. A first carry now. This is Williams. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets this football out shy of the 30 to the 29. A gain of 11 to kick off the drive, and it's a quick first down. Well, one unit I know you want to watch is that offensive line. If they keep clearing holes like that, it could be a long night defensively.
No doubt about it, because when they are in sync, as we're seeing so far, when that continuity is there and you can see that they're playing off of each other while controlling the defensive front linebackers, you're exactly right. It could be a very long night for the defense because someone's going to run for some big yardage.
They fake the give. Now Mahomes. And this one caught by Travis Kelce. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. That one good for 12 yards into Kansas City first.
Though Patrick Mahomes, guys, he's playing at such an elite level. Defensively, coming into a game like this, Charles, what it's got to be a lot of things, but what worries you the most?
I think you're exactly right about that. The list is extensive about what worries you. The way he can move, make completions on the run, the way he can throw against his body, heck, make left-handed throws, you name it, he gets it done. The biggest thing, though, is once he gets into rhythm, trying to get his timing chipped away, trying to stop that, that is really difficult to do.
The last run got 3. Now here's 2nd and 7. Looking to throw is Mahomes. Complete. The tight end, Kelce. 7 yards there and a first down.
That was a route run, not just with dexterity, but with intelligence.
found the hole in the zone, made sure the quarterback saw him, and was able to make the sure catch and flip the down marker back to one.
So the drive takes him into Giants territory now, first and 10 at the 48-yard line. Here's Mahomes to throw. A dump down to McKinnon. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40.
I like it. I like it. I like it. Get everyone involved in the passing game. And you know you can create those great mismatches throwing it to your guys out of the backfield.
And on the first drive, that can also help establish some rhythm, right?
I think so. And gets everyone involved. They feel like they're part of it and really gets them amped up as they go forward.
Here's Jerick McKinnon, his first carry of the ball game. And he gets it down to the 32. 7 yards there and a first down.
Yeah, once more, strong running, excellent blocking at the point of attack. They've got a nice little drive brewing right here.
From the 32 now, here's first and 10. On play action, it's Mahomes. And that is incomplete.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
Second and 10. Mahomes gonna throw. Eluding the pressure right. Stops short of the 25. The nice move couldn't ultimately free him. He'll end up getting 5 out of that, but now they're looking at third down. Now Mahomes. Escaping the pressure right. 8 yards that time. Able to take off, and the result is a first down.
That's something you have to be aware of as a defense and have to find a way to account for him. And if you're not going to use a spy, you're telling your guys to keep your eyes on him, because when he breaks out and makes plays like that, all he does is hurt you.
Have to at least be able to contain him somewhat. There they could not. So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. Operating from the red zone now, Mahomes. That's out to Hill, right side complete. And he will be brought down at about the 6-yard line. The Chiefs have got the passing game rolling a bit, and another first down.
And oftentimes we think about statement drives in the second halves of games, especially in the fourth quarter. But here, it's happening early, a definite statement. They've held on to the ball for a healthy portion this first quarter already, and now after that completion, they're set up first and goal.
A terrific opening drive has them knocking on the door, first and goal. From the gun, they will run with McKinnon. And he takes this into the end zone for a Chiefs touchdown. Jerick McKinnon. A 6-yard touchdown run. And the Chiefs take it right down and score on the opening drive. Let's make no bones about it. On paper, they're the better team. They're at home. That's a strong opening drive.
And just think how many times we've seen this type of a matchup. Just what you said, better team at home should steamroll them. And we've seen it go the other way. Sometimes, though, they buy into it and understand we are the better team. Let's go out and prove it right now.
Extra point by Butker is on target, and that makes the score 7-0. So that one a long 11-play drive, and it's capped off by a touchdown run of 6 yards. Now after after the touchdown. Here's Butker on to kick it away. And he'll just take a seat, and the drive will begin at the 25-yard line. The Giants ready to go to work on offense, and leading them out, their third-year quarterback from Duke, Daniel Jones.
I still remember when he was drafted, there was a little bit of controversy about how high he was selected by the New York Giants, but his talents were revealed. He can make every throw in the book. Surprisingly good athlete. As long as he takes care of the football, doesn't turn it over, he can really make plays.
Jones and the Giants now with a first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. Jones fakes the give to Barkley. And his throw is incomplete. Charles, already trailing by touchdown early. This offense, how imperative is it for them to get points out of this drive?
Well, they feel like they have to go ahead and match because of what was already on the board against their defense. But I think even more so, you just want to avoid three and outs. You want to be able to stay on the field for a little while, let your defense catch their breath a little bit, even if you don't score any points.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. They'll run for the first time with Saquon Barkley. Fighting through, and he's got space. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield.
Here we go.
A big chunk on the ground there, 27 yards. Well, with Saquon Barkley, you often think of the elusiveness, the quickness, but he can definitely run with purpose as well, and he's able to shed a tackler there and continue on.
And with a guy his size, you have to know defensively that arm tackles aren't going to fly with him. You have to be able to wrap up, or else he can just brush tacklers aside like they're not even there.
And the next-gen stats shows us the tale of how much yardage he was able to pick up after the initial contact. So now first and 10 in Chiefs territory at the 48-yard line. Now it's Barkley. Barkley hit, and the ball pops free. And I think the Chiefs have it. They do. Always costly to cough up that football. These defenders, they become so adept, though, at jarring it free.
Yeah, it's amazing that there aren't more fumbles caused, because now, if you're an offensive player, you go through ball security drills every single day. It's really not out of line to think you should take the ball to bed with you and just hold on to it. But the bottom line is, no matter how much you try to protect it, these guys are pretty good at finding ways to knock it out.
Mahomes will lead the Chiefs up first and 10 on their side of midfield at the 47. He'll hand this to Williams to start things out. And he can only manage to get a couple. Second and 8 coming up. We talk about defenders, specifically linebackers, keeping their eyes in the right spot. He had that eye down the entire time.
And you know that's not easily done, because they throw a lot of misdirection at you. They try and fool you and get your eyes in the wrong place. But you're right about that one. He correctly figured that one out and made a really nice play.
Meanwhile, Mahomes' throw here complete to Kelce. And he's got this down to the 35. It'll be a pickup of 16 and the Chiefs' first down.
And that's a more than acceptable read right there, because it's zone coverage. So timing is everything. This time he waits for his man to come open, puts it right on him, and they pick up a first down.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. They go play fake. Mahomes. And that going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down.
My first thought is surprise, because that's one of the better tight ends around, and I've seen him pull in balls like this before. But how about a little credit to the defense forcing that incompletion?
Here's second and 10. They go play action. Now Mahomes. He's going to find his tight end Gray complete. And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Giants 16. 19 yards to pick up there. Move the chains.
Yes!
After one, 7-0 on EA Sports.
Let's go. Let's do this.
Second quarter from Arrowhead. It's the Chiefs in possession as they've got it with a first and 10. Now they'll toss it out right to Williams. And he stopped immediately there. It was Reggie Ragland who got him down.
Well done to sniff that out defensively. He had it diagnosed pretty quickly.
I love that description because diagnosed is perfect on that one. Read his keys, made the play, and he couldn't even get going moving the football.
So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. Shotgun snap to Mahomes. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And the Chiefs are going to be looking at first and goal as they move this down to the four-yard line. And a good quarterback facing zone coverage, if he has just a little bit of time to survey the scene, that's what's going to happen.
No doubt about it. If there's no pressure, he's going to continue to pick them apart because he'll have all that time to find someone open downfield. You can only cover for so long. So maybe they want to go to a zone blitz scheme, get a little bit more pressure. Remember when Carolina did that against Denver? They lost the game ultimately. They dropped the defensive end out, and he ended up with an interception in that game in Super Bowl 50. Maybe some sort of scheme like that to try and get more pressure at the passer.
Second and goal from the one. Mahomes taps this forward. It's a jet sweep. And he will score. Touchdown, Kansas City. Mahomes finding Tyreek Hill. And the Chiefs are able to extend their lead.
So the touchdown there. And that play, the tap pass, so simple, Charles, on the face of it. But what makes it so difficult for defenses to stop?
I think it's the precision and the quickness in which the play occurs because the snap gets to the quarterback. He's essentially playing volleyball with it, just immediately just shoveling it forward. And when that receiver's at a full head of steam, if you don't take the edge away, he's got a chance to get to the corner and get upfield. But if you take the edge away, that's your chance to disrupt that play.
And no disruption there, that's for sure, as it winds up 6 points.
Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. Pettis now on the return. And he'll be tackled just shy of the 25.
Get ready! What are you doing, dog? What are you doing?
So the Giants getting the football back here for their second drive. And they had the fumble last time that led to a touchdown. That's a no-no. We'll see what they do here this go-around.
A big no-no. Put that in capital letters. Turning it over, the other team takes it down and scores. That can be a deflator for a football team. Now it's up to the offense to get back out on the field and pick things up.
You know, they're out there. We'll see if they can pick those things back up. Jones and the Giants now with a first and 10 at their own 24.
Now Jones. Throw left side, complete to Ingram. And he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. He was unable to shake free there, and they'll cover him for a loss of a yard.
In today's NFL, we're accustomed to the tight end getting downfield and creating plays and wreaking a little havoc in the secondary. Not on this one, though. They diagnosed that one really well.
Tried to dump off, lost yardage.
Second and 11. Throwing Jones. Jones in trouble here, and down he goes. Jaren Reed breaking through to get him to the ground. It's a loss of 7.
When you're down a couple of scores like this, CD, you can't afford too many plays that go in the wrong direction like that one.
Yeah, when you take a good look at it broadly, sacks are better than giving up an interception. but where they are on the scoreboard, they've got to get rid of all of that and just create positive plays for themselves in order to have a chance.
After that sack, third and long, tough spot for Jones and the Giants.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And that is incomplete.
Two drives won't tell the story of this game, but you absolutely have to like how this defense has played thus far. They have yet to allow this offense to get untracked in this one.
Fourth down, so on is the punter, Riley Dixon. It'll be a 39-yard punt, no return. And out will come the offense as they take over. The Chiefs ready to rock again on offense. And right now they're saying, hey, let's keep this going. Two drives, two touchdowns.
Yeah, can't ask for a better start than that, can you? I mean, this is the way you practice it. This is the way you rehearse it. But right now, the play calling, they're locked in really well.
Good starting field position for them here as they come up first and 10 at the 41-yard line. They begin the drive with Williams. And not much room to operate as he'll get this up only to about the 41. Dexter Lawrence that time in on the stop.
Well, sometimes you just have to give credit to the defense. Great job there at the point of attack, holding up. They won their battles at the line of scrimmage, left him no space to try and run. A really nice job swarming to the ball carrier.
The run only got a yard. Here's second and 9. Throwing now is Mahomes. He finds McKinnon, complete. And he'll be taken down at the 46-yard line. 5 yards, now it's third and 5. Looking to throw. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield, complete. And he will have a Chiefs first down by about a yard as they find a way to convert there on third down and 5.
Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon, and it looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time they pick up a first down. So now on defense, do you assign a man to him and try and cover him before he gets going?
Now a first down carry, it's Williams. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. An 11-yard pickup, and it's enough for a Chiefs first down.
For a lot of guys playing this game, there was no better feeling than running right through a tackle. He's able to lower his center of gravity and churn his legs for a really nice pickup.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Williams. And he'll manage to pick up about 4. It's second down.
Well, if you're a football guy, that's a pretty run because everyone is in sync right there. Obviously, the guy carrying the ball, but how about the people up front? Leverage, athleticism, they created some nice space for him.
Second quarter action with 1:59 remaining. Coming up at halftime in a little less than 2 minutes, we'll send you to Orlando where Jonathan Coachman is standing by. He'll have highlights and analysis of this first half. Mahomes' throw pulled in by Robinson here. And finally, down he goes as they work it inside the 10 to the 7. A good pickup there, 26 yards. Great mix of play calling so far. Three runs, three passes. All three passes have been completions. First and goal.
I think on defense now, you have to almost take a chance. Rely on your scouting, pick a play you think they would run here, and just load up for it and see what happens.
They scored touchdowns on drives one and two, and now they're trying to make it a perfect 3-for-3 to start.
Back to throw. And in for the Chiefs touchdown. Mahomes hitting his favorite target, Travis Kelce, on the touchdown pass. And the Chiefs are able to grow their lead. So simple math here in the first half. They've had three drives offensively, and they have scored every time, and they've got the lead.
Well, whenever we talk about adjustments, we usually talk about an offense making adjustments, right? This is all about the defense. They've got to figure out some way, somehow, to slow them down. Do they blitz a little bit more? Do they play more zone coverage? Right now, they don't know where to go because they're hitting them in every direction.
Butker on for the PAT. And it is now 21-0. So that winds up a 7-play drive all told. And it winds up with the Chiefs hitting pay dirt. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. Taken at the goal line. And he'll be stopped up at the 25.
Let's go, boys! Bring it up!
The possession switching back to the New York Giants. And in a spot like this, still more than a minute, I think if you put something on the board before halftime, that would go a long way towards helping them get back into the game.
There actually is something to the psychology of the game at times, isn't there? How much better would they feel running into the locker room, as you noted, with something on the board in a positive fashion? You're exactly right. It's a great opportunity to get that done.
Jones on first down. His throw incomplete.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Throwing again, Jones. That's complete. He's got Barkley out of the backfield. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. The extra effort after the catch makes it good for a gain of 26 and also a first down. Now a timeout called for by the offense, as they'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Back to throw, Jones. Out to the right here to Shepherd. Now the Giants will use the second of their three timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. Second and 5. They'll look to throw again. And he's going to be sacked. They sack him back right at the midfield stripe. Jaron Reed, his second sack of the night.
Three scores down, not even a halftime yet. They are not getting much generated offensively. They've got to figure it out.
It's tough because this defense just seems to be playing with so much confidence right now.
They really are. They are on their toes, and they're getting at them.
And that will be incomplete with a clock showing 18 seconds now to go.
I tell you, Brandon, this defense is playing with some confidence. Haven't allowed a point yet. Flying to the football. I'm telling you, it's almost 11 to the ball on every snap. Another nice job there to force an incompletion.
Here's Riley Dixon now. He'll boot it away from about his 35. This is away, but boy, headed straight for the sidelines. And the punt over the side in the air, and the spot will be inside the 35. KC offense out of the huddle, ready for their next drive. And with a three-score lead already, this is not time for a momentum change, so I'd imagine they'd be happy to just take this into the locker room. And he's not going to go anywhere as they get him down behind the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, second and 12. We have hit halftime. Still two more quarters to go. We'll take a timeout. We'll be back after this. You're watching the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. It's in the game.
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. And welcome in, everyone, to an abbreviated version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. First, though, time for a check of the next-gen stats from that first half for the Giants. And they will need to get this passing game in gear because they did not do much of anything in that first half. And it's why the scoreline is what it is. Meanwhile, for the Chiefs, we check out their numbers on the ground as they'll try to keep the momentum going into the second half.
All right, Coach, thank you. And we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. The Giants set to get the football, and they trail here as we get back underway in the second half. Pettis now on the return. And he'll get it up past the 20 to about the 22. The Giants about set to go to begin this third quarter. And you have to think, Charles, down three scores already. They need to play an almost perfect second half to have a solid chance.
And that absolutely starts with finding some way to put together a touchdown drive here. They need to be smart, fast, efficient, get the ball into the end zone, and do it again multiple times in order to have a chance to win this game.
Jones and the Giants now with a first and 10 at their own 22. They'll drop it off with Saquon Barkley. And not a whole lot of room to operate there on the first down run. He gets maybe three.
Defenses always talk about earning the right to rush the passer on third down. And you know what offenses want? Win first down so they can set things up for themselves better.
And that wasn't helpful there. Not a big impact on first down. 3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and 7. Again, it's Barkley. And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30.
Kid had a ton of success here so far, but you get the feeling that he might be on the verge of popping one.
Yeah, even on that one, there was a little bit of a hole, but it closed there quickly at the end. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Looking to throw. Jones. That's complete to Tony. The completion there lines up a wash, and it'll bring up fourth down.
Excuse my snarkiness here, but isn't the idea of completing a pass supposed to mean you get downfield and gain yards?
Especially on third down.
Yeah, that one. How about the defense? Figured that one out in a big way.
Yeah, they completed it all right and lost yardage.
Here's Riley Dixon now as he's on to punt for New York. It'll be 37 yards there on the punt.
Let's go.
So here's the Chiefs offense ready for their first reps in half number two. Mahomes will lead the Chiefs up first and 10 at the 33-yard line. Mahomes now to throw. And going deep for Hill. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
When you look at the scoreboard, you'd think they'd be pretty comfortable right now with this lead, but these guys are absolutely not going to let up. They want to increase their lead, and they want to do it with a big play. Unable to connect in that attempt.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. To throw, it's Mahomes. It's Kelsey on the ground. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. His fifth catch tonight, and it's good for a first down.
And while we may be looking at the scoreboard, this offense certainly is not, because they're showing no signs of backing down, even with a three-score lead here in the third quarter. I think they keep taking their shots. They've seen blown leads happen throughout this league. They don't want to fall victim to it themselves.
They fake the give. Now Mahomes. And he'll get this into the hands of Hill, complete. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. That'll be marked as a 27-yard pickup.
And time to give some credit to the big fellas, the offensive line here, because you've got to have good protection on crossing routes, because you've got to give your receiver time to work all the way across the field. That time, able to scan the field, spot his receiver moving left to right, and make a good, accurate throw. Thank you, guys.
So first and 10, and if they score on this drive, might have to start digging in our second half blowout material. Again, they'll throw with Mahomes. Screen play, McKinnon. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2.
With all the success they've had throwing the football as a pass rusher, you know you've got to come hard when you see him drop back to throw. So I really like this call to counteract that pass rush with a screen. It turns into positive yardage. A lot of times the offense says, just replace the rusher with the ball, and it turns into a good play.
Only needing 2 yards on second down. Now here's Mahomes. Open man is Hill. He's got it. And they corral him just a couple yards shy of the end zone. The Chiefs have got the passing game rolling a bit, and another first down.
Boy, how about the speed with which this offense can get down the field? It's taking them no time at all to get down here, and now they're set up with a first and goal.
They'll run it with Williams. Nothing doing there. They're going to wind up holding him at the 2. No gain there, and it's going to set up second and goal.
As usual, the hallmark of a good run defense, linebackers making plays near the line of scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run there.
Second and goal, and they will try again from the 2-yard line. Williams again, and he is in. Touchdown, Kansas City. Darrell Williams taking it in from 2 yards out, and the Chiefs add on to their lead. Just power football there, down near the goal line. Give it to him, he's able to push his way across.
Yeah, they went heavy there. Sometimes you have those big offensive linemen come in, have to report like they're eligible, but all they're doing is getting a good stance, blocking, and getting their runner across the goal line.
Extra point by Butker is on target, and that makes the score 28-0. So this drive spans seven plays, and it's culminated by a 2-yard touchdown run. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. Pettis now on the return. And he won't quite make it to the 25. New York ready to go again offensively.
They are right now just ice cold. I mean, they have struggled big time in this game, and they're getting blown out. How do they adjust?
So tough, because we always talk about it being a team game and you need all 11 working well together. But every now and then, partner, you need that one guy who can make a play against all odds that maybe can ignite things. And I think that's what they're looking for right now.
Yeah, you talk about going to your playmakers. They probably need to do it.
Find someone that you're used to touching the football that makes big plays and give them that opportunity to maybe wake up everyone else.
And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here.
45 yards rushing for him now to this point.
Now that was an excellent run. And when you see that happen, that's when you're seeing guys doing their job and then some people doing a little bit more. Offensive linemen and tight ends, they're expected to block. But the wide receivers, all they want to do is catch passes. So when they block on a big-time running play and create extra space, you've kind of hit the jackpot there.
Yeah, this will be a Giants first down as he's got this up to the 40-yard line.
Second and inches is oftentimes an invitation for an offense coordinator to take a big shot downfield because he feels like he can come back on third down and pick up the first down. But sometimes you just don't want to break tendency. Stay with what you are, stay with who you know, and go get the first down. That's exactly what they did.
And some strong running. Room here to run. And he's able to get this one down to the 40-yard line. That good for 19 and a first down.
Just a terrific run there, Charles, from a running back who is so compact and powerful, and that strength was on display there.
Yeah, and that's a run born out of ferociousness. He took on that initial contact and in his mind just screamed, out of my way, and kept right on going and wound up turning it into a big play.
And the next-gen stat shows us the tale of how much yardage he was able to pick up after the initial contact. Nothing in that first half, nothing on the last drive, but they're moving now with a first and 10.
Jones with a handoff to Barkley. They find some open field here.
And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. This. Another good gain. That's now 35 yards combined on those last two plays.
They're making it look easy out there. Another first down. So far on this drive, let me do this little bit of math here. Four plays, three first downs.
That's a pretty good recipe for success. Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move. First and 10. They'll try the right side here, Barkley. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. Dorian O'Daniel, third round pick in 2018, made the tackle.
Defensively, we always know that he is tough in run support, and I think the way that he gets there is he understands what an offense is gonna do before the ball's even snapped. A great job of scouting prior to the game, then reading, reacting, and taking the right path to the ball carrier.
And as they come to the line, they will not be able to get off another play as time has run out on this third quarter. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Looking to throw on second down. Jones. And the ball is out. Jones got hit and lost it. But I believe the Giants got this back, and they will hold on to the possession.
That's how we do it.
And a little bit of good fortune there. He wasn't able to get it back, but he did have a teammate on the spot able to retain possession for them.
So possession still theirs, but now they face a third down. Operating from the gun, Jones. Gonna throw deep for the end zone. And that is caught, but the back judge right there to say incomplete. Toward the back corner of the end zone, but he could not get the feet down. This will wind up incomplete.
Too many zeros on the stat sheet thus far. No touchdown passes, no points for his team, but he remains undaunted. Still attempting to get his team on the scoreboard, firing the ball downfield.
And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter, let's see how this plays out. As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. And Ingram hauls it in. And they will eventually get him down, but he's inside the five all the way to the three. No reason not to try it there, and they do indeed convert on fourth.
Well, this game is certainly pretty well over. They go to market in the win column, but as a defense, they don't want to get so soft now that everybody just throws the ball all over the place against them, gets big yardage, and puts points on the board. They have pride, too, on that side of the ball.
Barkley. And the D not yielding much there. He's only going to get a yard to about the two. What a game this defense continues to play, huh?
Yeah, they've been aggressive from the first snap, and they've controlled this ball game. But right now, if you're on the other side of the ball, you've got to match that aggressiveness. No points so far in this game. Moving the football, got to be that way to go against them and try and get some points on the board.
And I'm curious on the defensive side. And he will take it on in for a Giant touchdown.
Oh, boy.
Saquon Barkley taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Giants are finally into the end zone here in this fourth quarter. So the toss play effective, even down here near the goal line.
Yeah, and you're hoping the defense commits too many men to stop the run in the middle of the field and that your blockers can gain a little bit of an advantage. And when they do, foot race to the pylon, and this time he had the speed to win that race.
Graham Gano on for the extra point. He's got it to bring it back to 28-7 now. A 10-play drive that time. And it ends with a Saquon Barkley touchdown run. So still lots of work left to do, but here comes the onside kick. And the Chiefs are going to make the recovery. Well, fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of a anecdotal type of a number. Kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical.
On first down. It's Williams.
44 yards on the ground for him so far.
Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces. And I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
Second down, McKinnon. And this time, not quite to the 30. It'll be down at the 31-yard line. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down.
So many teams want to throw the ball in this situation nowadays, but I love watching a team that has enough confidence to go ahead and run the football in that situation. That's almost a tendency breaker.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Now a handoff. Here's Williams. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. No gain on the play there. Second down.
This defense, tough to run against. And those linebackers, they'll go side to side up the field, and there they get them for no gain.
If you can't get linemen upfield to the second level to occupy them, they have a field day just running to the football and putting ball carriers on the ground. Not many yards after contact when they wrap up like that.
Shifts by him. And they'll get this one to about the 20-yard line. An 11-yard pickup, and it's enough for a Chiefs first down.
We use the word relentless a lot with guys who are aggressive on the field. In this case, it really fits, doesn't it? How about his ability to break tackles, and his feet never stop moving?
First down, Mahomes. Mahomes hit. He lost the football. But it looks like the Chiefs are going to get it back.
Much like a running back going through the line, quarterbacks have to be aware of protecting the football as well. He left it exposed that time, wound up having it knocked free, but fortunately, had an alert teammate who was able to get it.
So they keep the ball, but work to do on second and long. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And they won't fare much better here as he maybe gets back to the line. No gain on the play this time, and it'll be a third and long situation coming up. Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So the Chiefs in possession of the ball as we welcome you back. They've got a third down now as they look for one more first down to help salt this one away. Open space inside the 10, and he gets it all the way down to the 3. Last play, they got stuffed at the line. Different story here, over 20 yards. Starting to look like this drive, it may be the final nail in the coffin.
Well, this is why you work out so hard, right? This is why you spend all that time in the offseason. This is why you have those OTAs and mini camps for these situations, these scenarios, to run someone into the ground and secure a victory.
They'll try and run. This is Williams. And he will take it on in for a Chiefs touchdown. Darrell Williams, his second touchdown of the night. And the Chiefs are able to extend their lead.
Well, there's just about a minute left in this game, and they're still taking it into the end zone. And you know they could have taken a knee there, but they decided to play this one all the way out. And I think their philosophy is, we're going to give you everything we've got. If we just go ahead and take a knee now, we're actually showing you disrespect that way, like taking pity on you. They're not about to do that to their opponent.
Butker now to add the extra point.
And he's been a busy man, 5 for 5 now, as he knocks another one through to extend the lead. So that drive goes 8 plays, and it ends with a 3-yard scoring run. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. Pettis now on the return. And he brings this out past the 20 to the 24.
Here we go.
New York set to take the field. Let's just be frank. They're playing for pride at this point.
That's all that's left, because victory, not a chance now. And I can't wait to see how they actually go about doing it, because there are a lot of people watching the body language of the guys on the field now. And if they call plays they want executed, they need to do that and do it really well. Otherwise, there could be repercussions.
We'll see how they handle the waning moments of this one. Jones now on 1st and 10. That'll be taken in there by Kenny Golladay. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Successful start to the drive, 17 yards, and moves the sticks.
Well, this game was decided a while ago, and that completion there is going to artificially inflate his passing numbers. So right now, the only one really applauding probably his agent, as he thinks about angling for a new contract.
One play has him up past the 40 already, and another 1st and 10. Back to throw, Jones. Jones in trouble here, and down he goes. Tershawn Wharton coming right up the gut. Gets in there for a loss of 9. The Giants going to go ahead and use the first of their timeouts, as they'll stop it with a little over 30 ticks to go in the football game. Pass protection has been a problem all night long as they come up facing 2nd and a bundle. Another try after the first down sack. Jones. Now Jones is hit. He lost the football. Now the Giants will use the 2nd of their 3 timeouts, as they'll stop the clock with 24 seconds to go in the game. So danger averted for the moment, but now here's a 3rd and long. From the gun, Jones. Now a desperation throw deep downfield, and incomplete on the deep ball.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, 4th quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. Here's Riley Dixon now, as he's on to punt for the 4th time tonight. Nifty move. Breaks through the contact. And he's able to get this one out closer to midfield across the 45. They'll score that a 36-yard punt. And control of the football switching hands here with very little time remaining in this contest. Victory in the cards now for the Chiefs as they take a knee here. So this one in the win column for Kansas City. And it was their defense that really paved the way to this victory, as they allowed the 1 touchdown, and that was all she wrote.
Almost want to do the defense chant right now, right? Defense with a couple of claps in there, but no one wants to hear that from me. Let's just talk about how they got it done, though. When you take care of every aspect of the game, shut down the run, control the airways, right? Make sure the quarterback is harassed. This type of performance you get. They can't fashion together any offense, no consistency, and they just took control.